Hi, I'm Surekha, Assistant Professor from Department of Pharmaceutics in Sri Ramnalamani Yadava College of Pharmacy. In this video, we are going to discuss about distribution law. Distribution law or the nurse distribution law gives a generalization which governs the distribution of a solute between two immiscible solvents. According to this law, if a solute A distributes between two immiscible solvents X and Y at a constant temperature, and the solute A distributes itself between the two liquids in such a way, then the ratio of its concentration in two solvents is a constant value. For example, take the 10 ml of water in a beaker and add 1 ml of oil in a beaker. The oil and water is two immiscible liquids, but the molecules are shared between them. The same procedure take by equal quantity of two immiscible liquids at a constant temperature, the number of molecules it shared between them. We know in aqueous solution is settled in the bottom of the beaker and organic solvents is present in the top of the water. But how much amount of molecules are shared between them? That is, C1 by C2 is equal to K. K means constant. C1 means concentration of A in solvent X, that means concentration of organic solvents. C2 means concentration of A in solvent Y, that means concentration of aqueous solution. K is the constant, also called the partition coefficient and also denoted by distribution constant, that is KD. Nernst distribution law. This is an equilibrium law. When the distribution of a solute A has reached a dynamic equilibrium. The dynamic equilibrium means a state of balance between continuing process. The rate R1 at which molecules of A pass from solvent X to Y is proportional to its concentration C1 in X. The rate R2 at which the molecules of A pass from the solvent Y to X is proportional to its concentration C2 in Y. Moreover, at equilibrium, the rate of solute migration from one solvent to the other is equal. So, R1 is directly proportional to C1, or R1 is equal to K1 into C1, and R2 is directly proportional to C2, or R2 is equal to K2 into C2, where K1 and K2 is constant. At equilibrium, R1 is equal to R2. So, K1 into C1 is equal to K2 into C2, or C1 by C2 is equal to K2 by K1 is equal to KD. This is the Nernst distribution law equation, and the distribution coefficient KD is also constant if temperature is fixed. Next one, deviation from distribution law. Several complications may arise which would influence the constancy of the partition coefficient. In few cases, deviation from distribution law has been attributed if there is alteration in the mutual solubility of two liquids as a result of increasing concentration. Next one, if molecular states of solute get changes in the two solvents, the change in the molecular state include when solute undergoes association in one of the solvent. That means KD is equal to C1 by N square root of C2. KD is equal to N square root of C1 by C2, where C1 and C2 are the concentration of solute in two bases. KD is called distribution coefficient or partition coefficient, and N is order of association. When the solute undergoes a dissociation in one of the solvent. That is, Kd is equal to C1 divided by C2 into 1 minus alpha. That means, per 1 unit, how much molecules was dissociated in aqueous solution. Next one, Kd is equal to C1, 1 minus alpha. That means, per 1 unit, how much molecules was dissociated in organic solvents, where alpha is degree of dissociation. Next one, the limitations of distribution law. There are following limitations of this law. First one, the solute should not react with any of the solvent. Second one, the solute must not undergo any change in its molecular states in the solvents. For example, it must not be dissociated or associated. Third one, the temperature should be constant throughout the experiment. Fourth one, the solute concentrations are noted after equilibrium is established. Fifth one, the solute concentration in both solvents is low. The law does not hold when concentrations are high. And the final one is applications of distribution law. The process is used for the separations of organic substance from aqueous solutions. The principle of distribution law is very useful in metallurgical operations. Metallurgical operations means is a process that is used for the extractions of metals in their pure form. The distribution law is useful in the study of complexions, hydrolysis of salts, and also determination of association and dissociation. In pharmaceutical industry, separation of many antibiotics, vitamins and hormones. Food industry, nuclear chemistry, fiber industry. Extractions of essential oil, extraction of caffeine from coffee and tea, removal of phenol from the wastewater, recovery and purifications of acetic acid from aqueous streams. Thank you for spending your valuable time watching this video. Thank you.